Good morning. Myself Prabhake, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, SVIT, Bangalore. Today I'll be teaching you the Module 5 of WC and LTE 4G broadband. Module 5 gives the information about data flow, radio resource management, and mobility management involved in LTE technology. Contents of Module 5 are EPS bearer service, PDCP overview, MAC or RLC overview, RRC overview, mobility management, inter-cell interference coordination. EPS bearer service. EPS means Evolved Packet System. It is a connection-oriented transmission network and it requires an establishment of virtual connection between two endpoints, that is the user equipment and packet data network gateway. This is the virtual connection, also called as EPS bearer, and it provides a transport service along with a specific quality of service attributes. The quality of service parameters associated to the bearer are QCI, that is Quality of Service Class Identifier, ARP, Address Resolution Protocol, GRB, Guaranteed Bitrate, AMBR, Aggregate Maximum Bitrate. These slides give you an architecture of EPS bearer service. It mainly includes the blocks, user equipments, eNode, service gateway, PDN gateway, peer entity. The interface between user equipment and eNode is called as eUtron, and the blocks between SGW and PGW is called as EPC, Evolved Packet Core. This is one diagram which also gives you the EPS bearer service. You can find out here the user equipment, which is your mobile, is connected to the tower, which is known as the base station. In technical term, we call it as the E-node. From here, the network continues up to servicing gateway and then PGW, that is the PDN gateway. The network between the user equipment and PGW is called as EPS bearer, and the network between the PGW and the internet, we call it as external bearer. LTE uses the concept of bearer as a central element of quality of service control. This bearer is defined between the packet data network gateway and the user equipment. EPS bearer has a cross multiple interfaces, and each interface is mapped to the particular transport layer of the bearer. An S5 or S8 bearer transports the packets of EPS bearer between the servicing gateway and the PDN gateway. The data radio bearer transports the packets of EPS bearer between the user equipment and eNode. When a data radio bearer exits, there is one-to-one mapping between the data radio bearer and the EPS bearer. An S1 bearer transports the packets of EPS bearer between eNode and the servicing gateway. The signaling radio bearers carries the radio's resource control signaling messages, and data radio bearer carries the user plane data. There is a two types of EPS bearer: default EPS bearer, dedicated EPS bearer. Default EPS bearer will be established during the attach process, and a proper IP address will be allocated to the user equipment. And during this process, there will not be any specific quality of service other than a nominal or a default quality of service which is applied to the connection established. Dedicated EPS bearer is normally established during call setup after an ideal mode, and no extra IP address, additional IP address is allocated to the UV. The default IP address is allocated to the UV. It is linked to a specified default EPS bearer which has a specific quality of services, and we call it as that as a guaranteed quality of services. The protocol architecture of LTE between the user equipment and the core network will be divided into two protocol stacks. First one is the user plane protocol stack, the second one is the control plane protocol stack. The user plane is responsible for transporting IP packets carrying an application specific data from packet data network gateway to the user equipment. This is done by encapsulating the IP packets in an evolved packet core with a specific protocol along with the tunneling using a GPRS tunneling protocol. The control plane is used for transporting signaling between mobility management entity and the user equipment. The type of signaling handled over the control plane is typically related to the bearer management, quality of service management, mobility management, including functions such as handover and paging. Coming to the second point, overview of PDCP. PDCP protocol layer exists in user equipment and e-node, and it is a part of LTE air interface for both control and user planes. PDCP means Packet Data Convergence Protocol. This protocol has a certain set of functions both in user plane as well as control plane. The main services and the functions of PDCP sublayer for the user plane include header compression and decompression using the ROHC protocol. ROHC means Robust Header Compression Protocol. It also performs a transfer of user data, in sequence delivery of upper layer packet data units at PDCP re-establishment procedure for RLC AM, duplicate detection of lower layer SDUs at PDCP re-establishment procedure for RLC AM, retransmission of PDCP SDUs at the handover of RLC AM. Regarding this AM, that is an acknowledgement mode of data transfer, I'll explain in the next coming slides. It also performs ciphering and deciphering of PDUs, nothing but coding and decoding of packet data units. Timer based service data units discarding in the uplink procedures. Similarly, the PDCP also has a certain functions related to the control plane, and those are ciphering and deciphering of control plane data, integrity protection and the integrity verification of control plane, and also the transfer of control plane data. These slides give you the information about the user plane and the control plane along with the functions done by the PDCP protocol. In a user plane, the PDCP protocol at the service access point performs first the sequence numbering of PDUs, then header compression, coding called as ciphering, and also adding the PDCP header to the generated PDUs. In a control plane, the PDCP entity first performs the sequence numbering of the control PDUs, integrity protection of the control PDUs, coding, and also adding its own header files to the PDU. We call it as PDCP header file. The PDCP packet data units are divided into two types: PDCP data PDU, PDCP control PDU. PDCP data PDU is used in both control plane and the user plane to transport the higher layer packets. It is used to convey either user plane data containing the IP packet or a control plane data containing the one radio resource control messages. The PDCP control PDU is used only within the user plane to convey PDCP status report during handover and feedback information for header compressions. In the diagram, it is clear that the first one is the user plane PDCP data PDU. Whatever the initial data that has received by this layer from its upper layer, it is considered, and then PDCP sequence number will be added and coding of the data takes place. Similarly, the control plane will take the PDCP data PDU and adds the PDCP sequence number. Coding of the data will be done, and then a MAC protocol used to control the media access. ROCH protocol is used for the compression of header files, and also an integrity is protected using the framework defined by the Internet Engineering Task Force. During the integrity and the ciphering in PDCP, it mainly includes the protection, that is the integrity protection and ciphering, with the help of a parameter called as count. This parameter is considered as a 32-bit wide register consisting of two parts. First part we call it as HFN, which is hyper frame number, and PDCP SN, PDCP sequence number. The SN is used for reordering and duplicate detection of radio link control packets at the receive end. Coming to the next topic, overview of MAC or RLC. The RLC layer performs the segmentation or and concatenation of PDCP PDUs, both control and data PDUs, and this segmentation and the concatenation procedure will be done according to the rules laid down by the MAC protocol. The RLC layer also supports automatic, that is the ARQ mechanism, automatic resend mechanism, which resides on the top of the MAC layer with the ARQ. The MAC layer only performs the task of multiplexing and prioritizing the various radio bearer associated with UV. The automatic repeat request is a mechanism that will be carried out if any of the packet has lost in the network. Then the network nodes can request the previous nodes to resend the packets using this ARQ mechanism. ARQ means automatic repeat request. HARQ is hybrid automatic repeat request. Regarding the data transfer modes related to the radio link control layer, there are three types of data modes, data transfer modes: TM, transparent mode, UM, unacknowledged mode, AM, acknowledged mode. Coming to the first one, transparent mode. The TM mode is the simplest one. In this, the RLC entity will not add any RLC header files to the PDU, and there will not be any data segmentation or a concatenation. That's why we call it is the simplest one. This mode is suitable for services that does not need any retransmission, and it is not sensitive to the delivery order, in which order the packets have been transmitted. That procedure is not followed in this transparent mode. The unacknowledged mode. The UM mode provides in sequence delivery of data that may be received out of sequence due to the HARQ process in the MAC protocol, but then there will not be any retransmission of last, that is a lost PDUs. This mode can be used by delay sensitivity network and in error tolerant real applications, real time applications. Acknowledge mode. The acknowledge mode is the most complex mode. In this, retransmission of missing PDU is carried out along with all other functionalities related to the UM mode. Next topic, purpose of MAC and RLC layers. MAC and RLC layers are responsible for transferring and receiving of PDUs, packet data units, from upper layers, that is from radio resource control, for the common control channel, that is the logical channel, and also for the PDCP from the other cases. It also takes care of error correction through automatic repeat request procedure. Any concatenation, segmentation, the reassembling of RLC service data units will be done by the MAC and RLC layer, and it is carried out only in the UM and AM mode of data transfer. Resegmentation of the PDU is carried out using this RLC layer, RLC protocols, and it will be done in AM mode of data transfer. In sequence delivery of upper layer PDUs, that is carried out only in UM and AM data transfer mode, and it is done by the MAC and RLC layers. It also detect any duplication of PDUs carried out in transfer through UM mode or AM mode of data transfer. Protocol error detection, and any error has occurred, the recover of the error will be accomplished using this MAC and RLC layer protocols. RLC SDU discard in uplink will be done by the same protocols, and RLC radio link control can be re-established if any error occurs during the network failure.